I kind of stumbled into journalism in my after graduating from college, and it's this wonderful excuse to indulge my curiosity. It's an opportunity to go and spend time with whoever I wish and pursue whatever ideas intrigue me. I can't imagine of a more fun way to spend one's life. My name is Malcolm Gladwell. I am a writer for The New Yorker magazine, and I'm the author of Tipping Point, Blink, Outliers, and What the Dog Saw. My new book is called, just out in paperback, is called What the Dog Saw, and it's a collection of my favorite articles from The New Yorker magazine. They're usually attempts to get inside someone else's head, to imagine the world through the eyes of someone who sees things differently than the rest of us. It's so weird. It's almost impossible to figure out. Oh, it's one of my favorite pieces. It's about Cesar Milan, who is has a show on television called The Dog Whisperer, which is, he's a kind of a dog trainer, and he goes to people's houses who have problematic dogs, and he tries to fix the dogs. I talked to all these sort of dog experts and tried to reconstruct the world through a dog's eyes. I got a bunch of dance movement experts, and they kept coming back to his, to how, first of all, how smooth what they called his phrasing was. So he's someone who, when he moved, moved with a kind of grace. And all that stuff is very important to a dog, a troubled dog, a dog that's already nervous and worried about the world and paranoid and overreacting to stimuli. It's very important that they see someone who has that kind of grace and calm and stability. I used to have very, very short hair, and then for a while, and then I grew my hair back out. And I discovered that the minute I did that, the world treated me differently. The minute I looked blacker, and I'm of mixed race, you know, I got stopped by police. You know, I was getting speeding tickets left and right. I mean, it was really kind of a striking transformation in the way the world viewed me. And it was that very kind of simple thing that led me to write my second book, Blink, which was an attempt to understand where our snap judgments come from and why they're so powerful and how and when they're right and how and when they're wrong. And they're more often wrong than they are right.